It's a 2020. It's not even that old, and we've already had to repair the roof on it because of actual leaks. I mean, that could cause. Well, thankfully, it never went inside the RV, but.
Well, I noticed another wet spot, and that new wet spot has creeped in to the area that I replaced. Welcome back. It has been a while since I posted. We have been traveling. We have been working, and then our RV has been parked, and we decided to plan a trip to Disney, and that's when I went on top of the roof to inspect it, and I noticed that there was one soft spot that needed attention. But well, we are done, and I'll tell you why we are done repairing this roof. The area that I replaced was fine. It's actually sitting right down there. I took it off because I said, wow, I wonder if my area is the area that failed, the area that I replaced, but it's not. The water's coming from somewhere. We have no idea where. You know, I may seem a little bum on this video, bummed out and a little sad, but I am. I have a right to be because I did this. This is not, I did this several months ago. I was excited that I fixed it. Like I said, it's not my area that failed. Just that we found another spot. So Sandy and I have an idea. We're gonna go ahead and clean this up. We're gonna go ahead and remove the insulation and put new insulation, dry it out, put the wood back, and we have an idea what we're gonna do. This is it. I insulated it. It has been a long day of me deciding what we are going to do with this patch. So I ended up insulating it. I ended up cleaning it up and putting the insulation. And now I'm going to go ahead and put this piece of plywood behind me on top of it. I ended up putting some more supports. This way we didn't have to worry about the swayness of it and the way it looks. So I spoke with somebody at a roof sealer company and he's like, hey, I'll take care of this for you. Just go ahead and seal it up. Make sure that it doesn't blow away as you're driving and get that thing over here. So guess what we're doing Monday morning? We're going for a little road trip. Through the steps, and he's going to show us how in the process of what it takes to seal our RV roof.
Today, final fix.
Final fix, the final RV repair roof you will ever need on your RV. We're taking you along with us. Damn, I should be recording you.
We just walk.
Damn.
Girl. We're probably working, so we'll probably just have to go in.
Thank you so much for taking our RV. I know that you were, what, like 8 weeks behind or something?
Yeah, well, we're busy because there's a lot of RVs that need work.
Yeah.
But we're happy to get it in and get it done.
And I appreciate you taking that, you making that exception, and you said I could drop it off and just you get to it whenever you did. But hey, I'll take the 2.5 weeks. That was perfect.
Yeah.
So.
Well, good. Well, hopefully when you look at the product, you'll be happy with that as well.
Oh, absolutely. I'm sure I will. I've read all your reviews, and every one of them was good.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, we did. So, and we liked the process. So I do want to say that I did have somebody give me a quote and to come out and do the RV armor.
Yeah.
I didn't want, it was the roll-on stuff, right?
And yeah, it's a liquid rubber membrane that they put on.
Yeah.
So it's basically the same thing as the rubber membrane you currently have in a liquid form that you can apply.
Yeah.
So.
And I definitely did not want that. Yep. That's why I love your process of stripping it all or whatever you do.
Yep.
And stuff like that. By the way, this is Eric from RV
Roof Greensboro.
RV Roof Greensboro.
Yep.
Look them up online at what's your
RVRoofGreensboro.com.
That's awesome.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yep. You can also find us on Facebook. We've got a lot of good videos, photos, people on there talking about the rigs that they've had done at our shop.
I love it.
And they're our best salesmen.
Yeah. Well, hopefully we could be your best salesman.
Yeah, there you go.
So Eric, I don't want to take too much time, but would you mind just giving a brief description of your product that you use? I mean, if you don't mind.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, so what we have is a two-part sprayed polyurea roofing system. Okay, what we do.
You don't have to worry about anything falling from the trees, like the cones?
No. Well, I've gotten a phone call from a guy that was in the Midwest when they had tornado warnings. There were 90 mile an hour winds.
What?
And in the middle of the night while he was sleeping, he heard a big crash on the top of his unit, and he couldn't go outside at night to check, but the next morning he was expecting to have some damage. And 2 weeks prior, we had done his roof.
Uh-huh.
He went outside, he pushed the log, he said, not the branch. He's like, it was a log I had to roll off the side of my unit, and he said there wasn't even a scratch on the thing.
Wow.
So I said, well, thanks for calling and giving me good news.
Absolutely. And this is where you get everything from, right?
Yeah.
All the reviews, and that's what we love to read.
Yep. Yeah.
Actually, that's what they love to read, is stuff like that. So.
Yeah.
I got to tell you, it was such an easy process of logging into your website, and you did that like automatic quote thing.
Yeah,
you
put instant quote feature.
Yeah, you put your information,
your
email address, and something, like, and then it automatically shoots it back to you or back to them with a quote. And that worked out so good, but my situation was I measured wrong.
Right.
I measured like the whole length of the RV, but you don't do that, right? You just do the roof.
Correct. So most people, they do exactly what you did. They do tongue to tail.
Yeah, that's
right?
What I did. Yeah,
that's what most people do. We're only going to charge off of what we actually spray.
Mm-hmm.
So once I spray the unit, we measure the actual chemical length, which is usually 4 to 6 inches above the front transition all the way to the rear transition. And that's where we're going to get our length from. So most people, when they get that instant quote, it ends up being cheaper than they originally thought.
Right.
Which is a good thing. I don't think people are usually mad about that.
It was a good thing. I'll tell you, when I did the quote, I was impressed with the quote because I know how much work detail.
Yeah.
But when I got the actual quote, I was like, wow, it's cheap. Oh, I see why. Because I subtracted the tail or whatever you call it, the tail.
Yeah, a lot of units have huge fiberglass caps on them. So, you know, if you've got a giant fiberglass cap, there's a good chance you can subtract 2 or 3 feet right off the top.
Yeah. So would you give us a little tour of your facility?
Absolutely.
Right.
We'll go up top and take a peek. Our guys are cracking into a rig right now. So
that's perfect.
The beginning parts of the process.
That's awesome. Yeah. All right, let's do it.
So I mean, you know, this one just got in here. Particular process that we use. These guys are just starting to do it. But yeah, we're gonna remove all of the components that you've got. The only thing that's gonna be left are the bases, and those bases are gonna be prepped. And once those bases are prepped, they're gonna get taped up to make sure that nothing gets inside, and that's how we're able to spray that stuff. But the process itself is extremely thorough. All this membrane, you know, most of these side rolls on these big rigs start to pop out because they're not stapled down good. So we're gonna make sure to staple those back and make sure that it's properly secured before we spray. So all this membrane on the side will get removed. So I would say normally you're gonna have anywhere from 30% to 40% of the membrane that's removed. But if it's bad, we pull it all up.
Right, right. Real quick, I know that the section where I repaired last year, it was just a small section. And then you tore it all out and replaced it. So I was a little confused because the wood that I replaced was yellow pine,
right?
And then the one you did had a green, but what is that green?
Yeah, that's actually a moisture barrier that they apply. So the moisture barrier, the reason we use that wood, one of the reasons is it helps with air coming through the wood. So since that barrier is already there, I don't have to worry about air coming up when I spray.
Okay, gotcha.
Because you could have things called pinholes that you have to go back and fix. So that it's called zip board, and they're actually using it on outside of houses and stuff now. Instead of using Tyvek wraps, they use zip board
as a
moisture barrier.
I did see that.
Yep.
I did see
that. This is actually one that we just did.
Oh, cool. We get to see a finished product. So we actually painted
the trim roll on this one.
I see that, yeah.
Yeah, so some people's rigs, they don't have any white in the rig like this one. So what we offer is a custom radius roll painting to try to match the rig. So people do like that. So this one's got that, and as you can see, the paint's drying on this one right now. Yeah. But yeah, you can really see the thickness up here.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that stuff's durable. Mm-hmm.
So I love how you do the skylights.
Yeah.
Okay, I like how you bring up the spray up to a certain height.
Yep.
And go all the way around it.
You don't lose any light by doing that, and you really gain some rigidity by doing that as well. That chemical, you want it to protect that skylight as much as possible if you are going
to
keep it.
Right, and that's the whole point, is to like make sure all this is sealed all the way around.
That's right.
The whole point of doing this.
Correct.
That's where most of your leaks come from.
That's the only thing that's going to be left on the rig before we spray. Are all the bases where there's any kind of puncture going into the roof.
Gotcha.
Because that's where your leaks happen.
Yeah.
So that's what we try to protect against.
And boy, I'll tell you, on my rig, I think we had a little screw on the side here. I think that's where it was all coming from. I think. I'm not sure. I don't know if you know anything more on that. Or
yeah, usually if you've got a screw on the side, you're going to get delamination on the side of the rig.
Oh, so it wouldn't...
Not usually.
Yeah, okay.
Usually the weather stripping, which we also encapsulate here, it's also encapsulated on your rig. That's where people get a lot of water into the screw heads, and then the delamination.
It just goes down. Okay, so mine was coming from the top then.
Yeah.
Because I did have subscribers say, oh no, that's coming from the top.
Yeah, it probably is coming
from the top. Yeah. So Sandy and I, one last question. Sandy and I were talking about on the way here about, I wonder if it's just travel RVs that have this. Well, here you go. You got a Class A?
Yep, Class A.
There it is.
There's your question.
Class C. That was my question. I'm like, I wonder if they have a different.
There's your answer.
Well, if you guys were in here a couple days ago, we had a horse trailer that we sprayed. We spray utility conversions all the time.
Yeah.
Yep, all of the above. Anything with a metal, fiberglass, or membrane roof, we'll spray it.
Gotcha.
Wow.
Gotcha.
Yeah. I love it. Do we need to look at ours, or how do you normally
do? It's up to you. I mean, you know, obviously it's outside.
Okay.
So if you needed to jump up there to look at it, I do have it open for you. So some people like to do a little walk.
Okay.
Well, let's look at the inside.
All right. Well, go ahead. Do you want me to go open the door for you?
Yes.
I want to see the new skylights. There's your baby rig.
There she is. Is that all your tools, Corrado?
Yeah, that's why I wanted to do both. Mm-hmm. I am definitely not going to... You know, I had this aluminum thing, and I seriously think this ruined the skylight because of the heat reflected and destroyed that. So I'm not doing that no more.
And that was in the bathroom, wasn't it?
That was in the bath. No, it was in the kitchen.
Oh,
it
the
was
kitchen cracked. Turned
yeah,
cracked?
The bathroom was fine, but I think we did both. Yeah, I had them do both.
You had them do both.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah, that roof is whenever you guys want to walk.
Yeah, I'll go. You want to walk? Want me to walk it, or are you good later?
Yeah, you can look at it.
Okay.
Look at.
See how thick, right there. Oh yeah.
I'm all look at that. I have to repeat them after I hear them.
Right away,
I notice around these edges here, how thick that is. And you can't, it's like plastic. Very, very, very thick.
You can see how he covered that. I wish you could come up here. You remember that skylight we had? I was able to push in.
Oh, you were?
Look. I was pushing in and out because it was so dry rotted. They do all around your vents. They remove your air conditioner. How they go all the way to
yeah,
the front.
It's thick out, because we're like 2.5 feet.
And I just want to get you an idea of how thick this is. You can see my finger. I like how they overlapped and they came over to the fiberglass. Wow, look how thick that is. You could see how thick that is.
Now everything, I mean, the world's changed.
So that's the insurance you should be paying for right there. Because now it's totally protected. No more surprises.
Very nice. Very nicely done all the way around. Look at that. All on the edges.
Yep. Yeah, it's actually a wire tape that we cut it with.
Okay.
So it gets all taped out, and there's a thin piece of wire in that tape, which is what the masking tape holds to. And then you put plastic from that masking tape. After you finish spraying the chemical, you have to do it pretty quick, because once it hardens, it's obviously going to be a lot harder to cut. But once you spray, you pull that wire, and that's what makes that clean cut.
That clean cut, yep.
But I mean, we can speak for experience, is that our rig is pretty new. It's a 2020.
Right.
And we already had a roof leak, and we tried to fix it, right. And then we had more issues, and it just, like, we already knew that we'd have to spend the extra money regardless, so.
Yeah. Yeah, it spirals.
You just don't think of it. You're like, oh, I already spent enough money on it. But really, you just want to protect your rig so you don't have any more surprises.
I wish I could tell that story to people at these shows, because the first thing they always
I
do
feel
when they
it
walk
right
up,
here.
They say, oh, I'm good right now. My rig's only a year or two old. I say, hey, I hear you. Just keep an eye
you're
out
like,
on it.
Here's the first aid band-aid if you need me. Just let me know.
I don't want to say that it's going to leak on you, but
Most likely, and especially when you're, we came from Michigan, and it wasn't, the weather up there, it's not brutal. You come down south, right? The amount of heat that's on our rigs now, and then the amount of people that own campers that don't have it covered, or or is at a storage unit like most of us, because we can't park it in our subs.
Right.
Those rigs are getting beat up. All the seals, everything is getting wore out, cracking, and now guess what you're gonna have?
Well, you know, I tell people all the time, they ask me, I'm debating on whether I should put up a shelter or if I should get a new roof put on. I say, well, the only thing I'll tell you is your shelter doesn't travel with you.
This is gonna
be with you at the campsite. This is gonna be with you at the beach. You know, if you want to park your unit for a month or 2 months, which people do all the time, hey, I'm going to vacation there for the summer. I'm going to book a 3-month slot at, you know, Myrtle Beach. And that's like, when you're gone and you're not there, if a leak happens and now you're not there for 3 or 4 weeks, that thing's going to be bad when
it's
get back.
It's going to warm up and mold quickly.
Like, so
that's a good point.
This shelter goes with you.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Excellent. This type of company would start up because of the need of it. And if it wasn't a need, it wouldn't be busy. So when you talk about the roof conditions, it's a 2020, it's not even that old, and we've already had to repair the roof on it because of actual leaks. I mean, that could cause, thankfully it never went inside the RV, but don't think you don't need it. Keep an eye on top of your roofs. If you're gonna get it fixed, make sure it's a permanent fix.
That's
and
right.
This is highly recommended. We'll go ahead and post all the details in the description below.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Of course.
Like I said, I appreciate you and your partner. Is it your partner, James,
In Atlanta.
In Atlanta. So you guys both own this one in Atlanta.
That's right.
That is pretty neat, because if you're on that side, you can go there.
Yep.
But if you're here in this side of North Carolina, you can come here.
Well, the great thing about this product is, since it's a FlexArmor applicator, if you go on rvroof.com, you can look at all the certified applicators. And I think right now there's 26 or 27 of them that do this system. But obviously, you know, I'm a fan of our shops.
Yeah,
my
definitely.
Partner shops. I know I can speak for us, and we do great work. But the FlexArmor product in itself is an incredible product.
Yeah,
I mean, it really is.
Well, with your permission, I'm going to put everything in my description of your website, your videos, your links, everything.
I would appreciate
that. Even your
that.
Contact information, everything. Only thing I won't do is pricing. You'll have to go get that yourself because I don't want, because pricing does change over the years. And this video is going to be here for 10 years, maybe. Anything you want to say? We'll close this video out later, but I want to settle up with Eric and we'll get going. So perfect. Thank you again for everything, Eric from RV
Roof Greensboro. Yes, sir.
I like how he finishes that. He finishes that for me. I like it. Yeah. So, well, thanks again.
Thank you.
All right. Well, that was an experience that I loved. I love those kind of experiences where you meet somebody that's very honest and a reputable company. So I'm glad we did this.
Me too.
So hey, thank you everyone for being here. Thank you for being patient with this video. And I hope
Hey, why are you breathing so heavy?
Because I just got done hooking up the Hensley, okay?
Take a breath.
So
it's because it's like the beginning of the season when you forgot how to do all the work.
Oh, I know. It's like it's like Christmas season, and then after Christmas you gotta lose like 5 pounds. But hey everybody, thanks for being here. I hope you enjoyed this video, and hopefully you see more of us. We look forward to seeing you guys, and catch you guys in the next video. Hit that bell and subscribe to this channel. See you guys later.
Come on, let's go. Get away from those Tootsie Rolls.
It's ready for Tootsie Rolls.
What are you doing?